One of the worst parts of prohibition is that it severely reduces the quality of drugs. Misrepresentation, selling one drug as another, and impurities are incredibly common. There's effectively no part of the drug market that's not affected by this issue, and it's largely caused by terrible laws. Although things will never be ideal with the current laws, there are ways to reduce the harm certain substances can bring. One of the best harm reduction tools is drug checking, which includes reagent tests, along with more advanced testing services. As part of the International Drug Checking Day, I wanted to briefly talk about how you can utilize these tools and why it's important. More information about drug checking will be available elsewhere on the Drug Classroom. Reagent tests are specific chemical mixtures that'll interact with components of certain drugs to yield a noticeable color. Some of the popular ones are Marquis, Mandolin, Mecki, Ehrlich, Lieberman, Simons, Freud, and Follin. You'll want to use various combinations of these depending on the drug you're testing. Because of how easy it is to use these tests and how high the consequences of not using them can be, I recommend nearly always using reagents with illicit drugs and research chemicals. You only need to use a tiny amount per test. A small visible amount of powder, either from a sample sold as a powder or scraped off a tablet, is all that's required. If you're testing blotter paper, about 1/10 of the blotter should be fine. For handling, make sure to not get the testing liquid on your skin. Don't touch the reagent bottle to the sample, and always wash off your testing surface when you're done. For storage, the shelf life will vary. You'll generally get at least 6 to 12 months of use if the liquids are stored in the dark and in a low temperature area, such as a refrigerator. As I don't yet have a video showing the testing process, I'm including links to two guides down below. The process is very simple. Use a small piece of your drug sample for testing. Apply one drop of the liquid to the substance. Now observe the color change that takes place over a period of 30 seconds. You'll want to pay attention to the immediate color reaction, as well as what the color becomes after. Now you just have to compare the reaction to a color chart. This process can be repeated with the different tiny samples, using different testing liquids to enhance the usefulness of this technique. For example, MDMA could be tested with Marquis, Mandolin, and Simons, while LSD could be tested with Ehrlich and Marquis. Adulterants and misrepresentation are found throughout the drug market. Some of the markets that have been particularly problematic are MDMA and LSD. The MDMA market has at various times and in various places contained drugs like PMA, PMMA, pipirazines, and substituted cathinones, while the LSD market has been affected by N-bombs and members of the DOX class. Although it's often possible to get the right drug if you're buying from the research chemical market, that's not always the case. There have been instances of vendors intentionally or unintentionally selling the wrong substance. So even if you're buying a drug that's technically legal, it should still be tested. There are dozens, if not hundreds, of research chemicals entering the market each year. Many of them continue to impact the aforementioned markets, and the problem isn't going to disappear without legalization. Some of these drugs, such as PMA, 25i-NBOME, and certain cathinones, have caused significant health issues and fatalities. When you don't know what you're taking, it's simply not possible to use the drug in a truly safe way. To figure out how your drug sample should react, there are a few resources you can turn to. The Bunk Police YouTube channel shows the results for a wide variety of substances. Another good option is using color charts from DanceSafe and others. You can also visit Ecstasy Data, which is associated with Arrowhead. Their drug listings often include reagent results. To use Ecstasy Data, you can visit the site and type in the drug you're looking for. If you pick a listing that has only come up with the single substance you're interested in, then the reagent results should be helpful. Browsing the site will also give you an idea of the adulterants that are present in any given drug market. The Bunk Police results and the DanceSafe results are quite reliable. I recommend using those resources first before turning to others, which is typically only needed for more obscure research chemicals. As there is the potential for a mistake in someone's posted results, you should look for multiple sources of verification to figure out the expected reaction. This kind of testing is far from perfect. A good result does not mean you have a pure or even an accurate drug. The benefit of using reagents, especially multiple tests, is that you'll reduce the likelihood of taking an unexpected drug, but you won't eliminate that chance. If your LSD, MDMA, cocaine, etc. shows up as something other than expected, you know not to put it in your body. With a good result, there's still the possibility that you're dealing with a substance that has the same reaction as the intended drug, or that the positive result is covering up adulterants. Both of these are distinct possibilities, yet they shouldn't keep you from utilizing the tests. Other technologies exist that are actually capable of identifying which drugs are in a sample. One of the tools is GCMS. It's an analytical method that can usually determine which substances are in a sample. The downside is that you must send your sample elsewhere to receive the results, and you may also have to pay a fee. Two of the largest services for GCMS drug checking are ecstasy data and energy control. Both come with a fee, and they'll accept samples from around the world. There are other local providers in various countries, some of which provide certain kinds of testing for free. You can find a list of the providers in the description. I have no financial connection to any test kit vendor, but I do want to mention a few that appear to have a good reputation. Of course, you should always do your own research. DanceSafe covers the US and global markets. Bunk Police operates in the US, and Reagent Tests UK operates in the UK and EU. I'd like to acknowledge the great work DanceSafe and Bunk Police have been doing. Not only have they helped inform the public, they are often present at music events to help people remain safer. Arrowhead's ecstasy data is also a remarkably valuable service, and is probably the best way to get a drug sample tested if you're in the US. As always, if you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments section. And if you'd like to support TDC, please visit patreon.com/thedrugclassroom.